because of lack of knowledge. And there down in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 4 and verse number 6 down, not because the knowledge is not there, but they have rejected. First and foremost, we as Kenyans, there are things that we have not done so far. We have not been faithful into obedience of the protocols. For example, if we agreed today, we Kenyans, all of us, wherever we are, we put the mask. The next 14 days, because the lifespan of this virus is 14 days, if everybody obeys and we go for the protocols, the next 14 days, this pandemic will be a gone thing. But we have ignored and rejected knowledge in terms of the what the Minister of Health has advised us in the protocols to be followed. Therefore, this is the consequences of our disobedience. I would urge every Kenyan to obey and follow the protocols, and we are going to be saved as a nation.
Yes.
This is where everything lies. It is not about the president. It is not about the parliament. It is not about governance. It is about individual Kenyans. Those who are mature and those who are young, we stand together and we obey and we follow. We are going to heal our nation. Otherwise, there is no any way we can escape the consequences of this disobedience until we come back to obey. Bishop Julius Mwangi Kidome, I minister with a church called Prayer and Revival Fire Ministry. We are situated in Thika Phase 5. Also, we do have other churches in various places in this country. We realized that there was a lot of deaths. People were dying. Until we realized, you know, we have to call God to come back. So, in the church, there is presence of God and the divine power to they that believe God. So, we would like to realize the same in our schools, and the government has to take all the cares necessary to make sure that the children are safe, because we don't know when this pandemic is going to be out of us. We've been faring with the COVID and fighting it as a nation, but of late, from the mouth of the government, it has been said that now no more funding as it concerns the COVID. And this one is causing a lot of fear and a lot of worries among the Kenyan people. However, even if the government is saying it has in our funds, me as a servant of God, I'm feeling that the government can revisit the matter and see how best funds can be available to help the needy as far as this sickness is concerned or this pandemic is concerned. So my prayer is that even Jesus, when he was going to heaven, he told his disciples that he's not going to leave them like orphans. He's going to go to the Father and ask the Father to send a help of the Holy Spirit. So even if things are not well as far as finances are concerned in the government, we still pray that the government should not leave us as orphans. The government must do something, should not desert us at this moment, because this is a very desperate moment. And if the government is able to get money for BBI, we feel still they can revisit it and have money for the health of the people. Because nationally is about the people who are health. But if we perish, or even the BBI will have no place to be, you know, articulated, because people will be gone. So my big prayers, and trying to put it across, is please, government, come again. What we have said of late is leaving us like people who have got no hope. But since you are the government and you have all the masses, we ask you to come again. BBI, well, it is there. and let it not become a poison to the mwananchi. So kumbukeni mwananchi, and without people there is no government. So please revisit the matter. We are asking, me, myself,